the sacred Egyptian site of Karnak. Generation after generation of pharaohs built temples here in honor of their own rule. The result is a sprawling city of religious structures from different eras, packed together like sardines. Karnak sits at the heart of the Egyptian Empire, 300 miles south of the Great Pyramids. This vast collection of religious buildings was also a seat of power for Egypt's mighty pharaohs, like today's Vatican and White House rolled into one. What really went on behind these hallowed walls? Today, as engineers rebuild the shattered remains of Karnak, piece by piece, this extraordinary site is finally revealing its hidden secrets. It's a mammoth task.
There is huge blocks everywhere, different kind, different periods. It's like a puzzle, huge, big puzzle.
The parts of the complex archaeologists have restored revealed the spectacle that greeted elite guests more than 3,000 years ago. The elite allowed to enter Karnak were greeted by the massive hypostyle hall. Here, foreign dignitaries were received, and mighty pharaohs rested under the shaded columns. Behind it, the festival hall obelisks marked an exclusive gateway. Only priests and pharaohs could pass through to the inner temples. At the heart of this secret inner sanctum lay the most ancient known temple. But experts suspect that this site was venerated for so long that even older temples may lie hidden in the ruins. Antoine Garric is the current lead on a massive restoration project, rebuilding Karnak to its former glory. He knows that ancient structures, unseen for thousands of years, could lie hidden inside this field of blocks. But to resurrect them, he first has to find the right pieces.
Okay, we are in the blockyard south of Karnak Temple. There is thousands of blocks. That's where it all starts.
While hunting out the blocks for his latest reconstruction project, Antoine has learned something astonishing about the Egyptian builders. They were thieves.
Every pharaoh was dismantling other monuments and also reusing that block. If you turn a block, you discover a new face just behind.
Examining the scenes of these architectural crimes reveals some incredible surprises. Perhaps the greatest was discovered inside the ruins of one of Karnak's enormous walls. Within the fabric of a half-destroyed wall, archaeologists found the remains of hundreds of stolen blocks. They're the pieces to a near-complete temple called the White Chapel, the crowning glory of Senusret I, a former pharaoh. He covered the chapel in inscriptions, depicting his Jubilee festival. It once held the king's mighty double throne and honored the sun god. This holy shrine was callously destroyed to build the legacy of a future pharaoh. 9 similar towering walls were built on the Karnak site. The pharaohs that built each one covered them with ancient scripts, boasting of their divine status like a giant billboard. Today, Antoine and his team are reconstructing one of the walls. They believe it was carved in honor of the boy king Tutankhamun more than 3,000 years ago. By completing this 30-foot-high jigsaw puzzle, Antoine hopes to reveal the forgotten history of King Tut's reign, scrubbed out by the rulers who followed him. The complexity of the task is enormous. But Antoine has technology on his side.
instead to make a huge scaffolding to measure the all walls, you know, to have to go 10 meters high. It's not needed. We just take photo from the ground. We have also to measure all the blocks in order to make the rebuilding first on the computer.
Antoine uses special software to see where his photos fit into the wall reconstruction.
When you click and you move your block, you can move it right and left. Draw on it, I can measure on it. So that's really faster than instead to build a scaffolding to measure all the blocks one by one, just with few pictures, and it's done.
Once he's sure where the virtual block goes, Antoine can haul the real thing into place.
We have half of the scene on that block. We just have to adjust perfectly the block with the other joint.
Antoine is confident this is the next piece in King Tut's monster puzzle. Antoine now needs to line up the inscriptions perfectly to finish the job.
So we have to lift a little bit the block in order to reach the good height. It's more difficult because we have no space here on the side to put levels, so it's more tricky, but no, it's okay.
Antoine and his team use brute force, just as the Egyptians would have done. No technology can help with the final few fractions of an inch.
So now it matches perfectly together. We have the king's throne here. All the lines are matching together, so we are okay. It's horizontal. The angle is okay. It's fitting to the ancient wall, so it's perfect.
The block is back in its original ancient location. Tutankhamun's wall is one stone closer to being complete.
We are setting the blocks on new stones, so we have space between the old blocks and the new ones, so we can fill it with a lime mortar.
Antoine uses modern techniques to set this block in place. But getting this close to the Egyptians' handiwork allows him to see how they completed the same task.
In the ancient time, they were doing mortar with a kind of liquid mortar, because the joint will be very thin.
The ancient Egyptians made special vertical grooves to pour the liquid mortar between the extremely tight joints.
The liquid mortar was put it here to seal the joint.
Today's restorers are lucky to have modern machines to lift the 2-ton blocks into place. 3,500 years ago, the Egyptians had to use much more primitive tools. Instead of cranes, the ancient Egyptians made bricks from the mud of the Nile and stacked them into a gently sloping ramp. They added wooden tracks and pulled the massive stone blocks up on sleds. They used water to lubricate the path. The Egyptians built the ramp higher and higher to add more and more layers to the wall, until it towered over 100 feet. Once the wall was complete, the ramp was destroyed. A huge wooden door and colorful flags were added as the final touches.